If you've never heard of artist Therese Nielsen or Magic the Gathering, well, you're about to. Because when it comes to social justice, social media mobs, not even the niche world of Magic the Gathering is safe.
Quiet in the peanut gallery, please.
4 damage to your planeswalker.
Oh! Therese Nielsen is a veteran artist known for her work with Marvel, her cover art for some Star Wars novels, and most notably, her work with Wizards of the Coast for their popular Magic the Gathering card game. If you play Magic and don't know her art, pull out your Force of Will or your Guru Lands if you have them. That's her. If you don't play Magic, then just know that it's a card game that about 20 million people play worldwide, and the cards with her art on them are really, really popular. But now, Nielsen is the target of a social media mob that's demanding players destroy their Nielsen cards, or even worse, trying to get her blacklisted from Magic completely. What was her crime? Well, you see, it was liking Sean Hannity on Twitter. This makes her a racist, bigoted, transphobic, sexist, fascist, homophobe, despite the fact that she herself is a lesbian and is married to a woman. Now, if she's truly a racist, bigot, sexist, transphobic, fascist, or homophobic, that's bad. All of those isms are morally wrong. I think that's something that most people can agree with. The weird thing about it, though, is that no one can actually prove that she's a racist, transphobic, sexist, homophobic bigot. Because she's never posted anything to support those views. Ever. But as far as I can tell, every time someone points that out or asks for concrete evidence, they're told to check their privilege, or that I didn't take screenshots, or even better, well, she liked some things on Twitter back in 2016. These alleged likes, by the way, are now nowhere to be found.
That's a twist. That's very twisty.
And yet, a vocal minority of the Magic community has decided that she is a Trump supporter, though no one has dug up her voting records, no political donations, no rally attendance, nothing. There is no proof that she's a Trumper or any of the isms whatsoever. Nevertheless, her likes on Twitter are proof that she personally wants this Twitter user dead, for example. After all, according to NutDraw on Reddit, liking conservatives on Twitter is basically the same as hate speech. Twitter follows are also proof that Nielsen actively endorses and supports racism and bigotry of all forms. Her views, which no one actually knows for sure, are nothing more than a plague on actual good people who would never in a million years consider stooping so disgustingly low as to support the kinds of ideas that you do. Now, you might be wondering why an artist liking things on Twitter back in 2016 is suddenly a big deal now. Well, apparently it was a very big deal for a small set of Magic players since day one, but Nielsen recently announced a new project that will be backed by a Kickstarter, and this loud minority took up arms to try and convince the depths of Twitter and Reddit not to donate, for Wizards to never commission her again, and for the new project to die because Twitter follows our oppression. So what are these likes and follows? Well, you see, the thing is, no one has screenshots, or at least they say that they mistakenly deleted them. Other people have gone the weird and creepy route of tracking down her wife's Twitter and looking at her wife's follows and using that as proof, even though last time I checked they are two different people and people are capable of having different views than their spouses. This is about all I could find. Just about any post or article I could find on the subject linked back to this, a reposted Tumblr blog from August of 2017 that shows a couple of tweets about the Boston Free Speech Rally. To everyone in Boston, are these some of the white supremacist Nazis you are rioting over? Sure, the people in the photo are holding up a Trump sign. She could have liked it because of the Trump sign. She could have liked it as a stance against the now common misuse of the label white supremacist. She could have liked it as a stance against racism. She could have even liked it as a fan of free speech. The same could be said about two of the other tweets referenced, one of which was a tweet against Antifa, who have a history of being pretty fascist themselves. The fourth one really has nothing to do with anything, but is still clearly pure evil. Though I also found these, digging deep into the Twitter rabbit hole, posted by someone who believed them to be absolute proof that Nielsen is a card-carrying member of the alt-right. This tweet from Sean Hannity calling out the liberal double standard, and these tweets against a bailout and another about firing Congress, which I honestly think is a splendid idea. But these tweets especially were proof enough for some Redditors to accuse her of being genocidal, and for this Facebook user to come out with the doom saying that liking tweets will have larger repercussions to society in general if it's allowed to continue. Have these people never heard of the block button, or is this just a feature not available on social justice Twitter? The irony here is that in defense of these accusations, some people have screenshotted this tweet from Nielsen's wife saying how it's harder to be a lesbian who voted for Trump than it was to come out of the closet 25 years ago. By using this tweet as their evidence, they're kind of proving her point.
A little too ironic. And yeah, I really do think.
And that's the extent of it. That's really about all this camp has. Any arguments on Twitter about trying to separate the art from the artist apparently gets you blocked, as one user proudly proclaimed blocking almost 500 people over it. 500! When others point out that Nielsen isn't guilty of any crimes, unless you're one of those people that use 1984 as your playbook, you get responses like this, claiming that the thoughts are crime enough because people don't actually join the KKK anymore. Personally, I think that racists not taking action to actually follow through on their racism is at least a step in the right direction, but apparently it's not, and so we need to throw out more babies with the bathwater just to be sure. Some have said, well, she follows Trump and Sean Hannity and Project Veritas and Mike Cernovich and Paul Joseph Watson on Twitter. Oh no! Okay, but she also follows Hillary Clinton, Adam Schiff, Obama, Jill Stein, Bernie Sanders, and the Dalai Lama. So that means nothing. I personally follow all kinds of politicians and journalists I don't agree with because I want to see what they're actually saying and, I don't know, keep up with the news? She even follows an account called MTG Diversity, a group whose whole mission statement is about creating a gaming environment that is welcoming, inclusive, and accessible to everyone, regardless of their gender, gender identity, sexual orientation, age, race, religion, ability, or anything else that has nothing to do with the game. That doesn't sound super fashy to me. The responses, on the other hand, super fashy. Angry players are searching out artists to deface their cards and playmats, for example. Others are threatening to destroy their cards completely in protest. Let me repeat, they're going to stick it to the man by destroying things they have already spent money on. That is some rocket science right there. For the record, at the time that I wrote this video, the market price for a near-mint Alliance's Force of Will on TCG Player was $111. So this photo right here is about $450 that is now considered damaged goods when it could have, say, I don't know, been sold off, and then maybe that money could have been donated to an LGBT charity or activism group. But I mean, I know, that's not very ragey. Ooh, I know, let's destroy some of those guru lands too and waste another several hundred dollars. That will show Wizards of the Coast not to hire bigots. In answer to all of this, Nielsen posted a statement. Not an apology, just a statement. And as of right now, this post on April 2nd is the last thing that she has posted on Twitter. The statement talks about how being excommunicated from a community and ostracized by my family for following my convictions is nothing new to her, as she received similar comments and treatment when she married her wife 25 years ago. She speaks about being a seeker of knowledge, including ideas and philosophies from all corners of the planet, and that pushing into the messy contrast of diverse and often conflicting viewpoints is a duty I owe myself, and that people should be able to coexist peacefully even with differing opinions. She goes on to say, I understand that we live in a world of duality. One can be elevated to levels undeserved and flogged as less than human with the next stroke of a keyboard. I embrace the fact that many different viewpoints can, do, and should coexist. In these stressful and tumultuous times, it is my intent to navigate in harmony with my core values, beauty, compassion, love, to the best of my ability without any need or desire to stifle, censor, or demean another for differently held viewpoints. Spoiler alert, the woke community? Didn't like that. As far as I can tell, most people are supportive of this and of Nielsen, but the woke community, they interpreted this as her falsely claiming to be marginalized, even though the letter claims her own Mormon community compared her to Charles Manson for being gay. According to this user, all the letter does is confirm that Nielsen is a lesbian Uncle Tom. Other popular interpretations include, I am in league with neo-fascists. Please stop talking about me so that I can continue to make money off the Hasbro toy company. Here is a long statement that is neither an apology nor an acknowledgement of any of that. And, if I'm reading this correctly, it's a long-winded way of saying I support white supremacists who throw kids in concentration camps. So I think we're having some issues with reading comprehension. The good news, like I said before, is that this seems to be a very vocal, but a very small minority. A lot more people have come out in support of Nielsen than against her. As far as I can tell, the token project for Kickstarter has not been canceled and is still going to be launched on May 14th. And Wizards of the Coast hasn't decided to cut her loose, at least not yet. Or I guess I should say, at least not publicly. If only the other targets of today's outrage culture could be so lucky. That is your Liberty-related news of the week. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Drop a comment down below. Let me know what you think about this whole ridiculous situation, or if you've ever been the target of any of these social justice mobs. And if you really like my channel and want to help support it in other ways besides just having a conversation, you can do so over at Patreon or through a one-time donation through PayPal or crypto. As always, thanks for watching and helping me to spread the message of Liberty.